Lisa Niver 是一位住在美国洛杉矶的旅游专栏作家，他走遍了世界上100多个国家，撰写了2000多篇旅行札记，在包括《国家地理》《时尚》《周六晚报》《探索者》《今日美国》等在内的多个媒体上发表。Lisa 的 YouTube 频道观看量超过200万，他曾2度被《今日美国》评为全美10家旅游直播，3次获得南加州新闻奖，2次获得美国国家艺术与娱乐新闻奖。Lisa 曾几度到中国深度旅行，并撰写了 China Make Good Choices 去中国吧，做正确的选择的博文。今天酷爱到中国旅行的 Lisa 想要写一写她最新发现的一处奇妙的文化遗产——北京中轴线。
I've been to Beijing a couple of different times, but I loved being in the Forbidden City, Tian'anmen Square.When we were allowed to walk inside is always to see the incredible ceramics and the colors and just the incredible details. I remember we saw one roof and it was like a dragon had scales along the roof, like which is so intricate. So one of the things that I've been really interested in is learning more about China.
喜欢中国的 Lisa 自然很关心中国的旅游动态。网络上的这位博主的视频引起了他的好奇。
为什么中国的城市很多都有中轴线？因为所有的原始人类最早出现都是生活在像河流这样的水源边。那随着部落人数的逐渐扩大，有了最早的城市。而到了元明清时期，北京呢就出现了这条全长 7.8 公里的城市中轴线。
I loved learning from the Chinese blogger. I've gotten to explore many different UNESCO World Heritage sites.So in India, I saw many different World Heritage sites, the Konark, the Sun Temple in Konark. In Palau, I've been to the Rock Islands, which is definitely listed as an incredible site. Obviously, in China, there's many different World Heritage sites. So I have been to the Forbidden City and Tian'anmen Square, but I never heard of this term, Beijing Central Axis.
I look forward to learning more about other historical architecture and all the parts of the Beijing Central Axis.
北京中轴线纵贯北京老城，全长 7.8 公里，是指北京自元大都、明清朝代以来，北京城市东西对称布局建筑物的对称轴。北京市诸多地标性建筑都在中轴线上。北京中轴线的北端是钟鼓楼，向南经过万宁桥、景山、故宫、端门、天安门、外金水桥、天安门广场及其建筑群、正阳门。中轴线南段道路遗存至南端永定门、太庙和社稷坛、天坛和先农坛，东西对称布局于两侧。依据规划，这15处建筑及遗存是中轴线遗产的构成要素。
With the central plaza and the Beijing spine reminds me of being in some of the most amazing plazas all throughout Europe. One of my favorite countries to visit is Spain. I love Gaudi's architecture in Barcelona. But one of my favorite things is to wander around in Madrid and see the incredible museums.
Lisa 最喜欢去旅行的欧洲国家是西班牙。当她听说了北京中轴线时，自然而然地联想到了西班牙的世界文化遗产，而网络上发布的一则在北京与马德里之间的专家对话，让他了解到北京中轴线也是海外华侨华人向往的地方。
那么有一句话给我留下了非常深刻的印象，就是中轴线是北京的灵魂和脊梁。那么我们是否可以说中轴线就是北京这个人的脊椎骨呢？
中轴线上这些建筑都是在城市发展的过程当中首先把它要定下来，才决定我们说的周边和它对称的这种布局的关系。所以它确实是串起了整个城市，它甚至会向南向北的延伸，而构成一个更宏大的一个这个国家的国土空间的关系。
假如要是说有外国友人和海外的华侨华人想要了解一下中轴线文化的话，那么有什么地方您认为是最为推荐的五星推荐之一？
第一推荐呢，我想还是在中轴线上的景山。你在这儿可以俯瞰整个中轴线， 他会完全从不同的角度来理解这个城市，理解我们说的包括像故宫，包括这些建筑之间的关系，来理解什么是中轴线。
Listening to the professors talk about Beijing Central Axis, I can't wait to go back to Beijing and climb up on Jingshan and see from a different perspective, you know, how the Central Axis, all the buildings were planned and it's symmetrical on the east and the west and it goes from north to south. Understand the, it's the spine of the city, but also the heart. So one of my favorite things is to see how cities have evolved.I'm looking forward to finding out about the new developments with the Beijing Central Axis.
为什么这个08年的奥运会它还是要放在这个北京中轴线的北端是吧？它的布局还是要这个以中轴线两边对称，就是要把圆形的这个鸟巢的这个体育场放在这个中轴线的东侧，然后要把水立方这样的一个方形的建筑放在中轴线的西侧。这也是圆和方对应，你看天坛是在这个中轴线的东侧啊，然后这个山川坛是在中轴线的西侧，我想这种观念是一直在延续，影响着我们今天对于城市环境的塑造。
The Olympics are very near and dear to my heart because in 1984,When I was 16, the Olympics were in Los Angeles, and I got to be part of the opening ceremonies. And it's incredible to me the way that the Chinese architects were able to encompass the Beijing Central Axis. So it was my honor to be able to learn so much from Professor Lu Zhou about the Beijing Central Axis. And I look forward to being able to share this information and writing an article about Beijing's spine.This is a chance to learn more about the important ancient history of China and the way it's continuing even in the present with the Olympics and all the new construction that's going to happen.